Welcome to BPM Stuff. No need for any long-winded introductions. Let's just get straight into it. These are my top 10 albums of 2021. Number 10, Mach-Hommy, Pray for Haiti. It's saying that I'm top one, more or less the best. Let's travel through the vortex when Gore-Tex was a flex. Used to rock the 4X, I throw a hex, you vex. Texting like a scorn X while I'm getting neck. Only concern is getting more checks. One of the best rap albums of the year. The beats are consistently fantastic, sounding like a modern twist on classic hip-hop instrumentals. The flow sits so well in these beats that it's hard to imagine the two separate. They hate to see a dog balling like a mellow, sour amaretto, your heart made out of jello, pop tarts and marshmallow. Unlike the fashion rebels who blast the bomb schedule, real thugs who palmetto from head to palmetto. The bars are clever and imaginative, the punchlines land. The only downside of this record is its lack of ambition at times. The album is really just a collection of excellent songs showcasing Mach-Hommy, but without much of a core theme or idea to bring it all together. Number 9, Jasmine Sullivan, Hotels. Although technically released as an EP, it's 14 tracks long, and it feels unfair to not include it here due to that small technicality. A gorgeous R&B record, it features six spoken word pieces, stylized as tales, in which six different women discuss personal observations about sex and its consequences. The music is beautiful, the storytelling is excellent, but the vocals are even better. You'd be hard pressed to find more soulful singing on any release this year. And it breaks us to the core. You must want something different. Still don't know what I was missing. What you asked, I would have given. It ain't right. How these hoes be winning? What ain't. Number 8, Tyler the Creator, Call Me If You Get Lost. Tyler's sixth album is his most ambitious yet. This album feels like a victory lap, as he incorporates many of the sounds and experimentation of his previous albums and builds on them. I might buy a boat. Depends if Capri got space, don't really need one. I could go on the one at time, baby, I believe some. Find another nigga like me, cause I ain't seen none. Pull up in that, whatchamacallit. Played a couple demos at Madison Square Garden. And tell them motherfuckers that Sony I'm not calling. I'm plotting on a Billy Chili in my garden. Everything feels intentional here. This album is layered with themes, both musical and lyrical. The accompanying visuals are excellent, although the influence of Wes Anderson on him is abundantly clear. No one else except Tyler could have made this record. Number 7, Spirit of the Beehive, Entertainment Death.
Hold on, sis. Let's start at the beginning.
It's almost impossible to believe that an album with this much going on was made by only three people. Some songs in this album have more ideas and experimentation than most bands do in their entire careers.
Yeah.
sonically huge, eccentric beast that manages to be both approachable and fun. Listening to this, you get the feeling that they could make something more conventional and easy listening, but that would be boring. Number 6. Little Sims, Sometimes I Might Be Introvert.
The kingdom's on fire, the blood of a young messiah. I see sinners in a church, I see sinners in a church. Sometimes I might be introvert, there's a war inside, I hear battle cries.
Few artists can make an album as deeply moving and personal as this. Few artists can seamlessly blend huge orchestral instrumentals, hip-hop, R&B and Afrobeat. Little Sims does both. Family no go so far, oh, in my lifetime. They be fine doing proper, no lie, give me strength, let me prosper. Daddy say you want me to be lawyer, be doctor, riffraff, kiddy gone, window shopper, oh yeah, fine boy. This album not only acted as both an introduction to Little Sims for many people, but it has also cemented her as an important and influential artist. Everyone should listen to this album at least once. Niger women got the melanin dripping. Ella Wendy, O-N, city girl living in the back, looking like fire, chili pepper. You're a bad girl, tougher than imperial leather. He was getting bitter while she was getting better. Diamonds are forever. Miss Sierra Leone looking like a gem. Works hard in the week, party on the weekend. Number 5. Nala Sinefro, Space 1.8. One of the greatest debut albums in recent memory. The tracks are titled Space 1 through 8, which feels appropriate as each feels and sounds like a different space. The arrangements are beautiful. The warm ambient chords wash over you like the best of Aphex Twin. Nala Sinefro is one to watch in the future. Number 4. Maria Arnal y Marcel Bajet, Clamor. The synths are warm, the vocals are stunning. Listen to the melodies, the accompanying harmonies, and the sound design. We seamlessly move from vocals that sound like a lullaby to strings playing dissonant cluster chords. Number 3. Floating Points, Pharoah Sanders, and the London Symphony Orchestra, promises. This album isn't a reflection of the amazing talent that worked on it. In fact, it's even better than that. Listening to this is genuinely a spiritual experience. It's subtle and thoughtful. If you're planning to listen to this album for the first time, you should do absolutely nothing else. Just listen. Number 2, Black Midi, Cavalcade. Black Midi's second album is bigger and bolder than their first. A cacophony of slint-like post-rock, crooning, math rock and jazz. There's so many surprise twists and turns on this album, but none of them feel random. They feel intentional and bizarrely natural. The performances and songwriting are second to none. At this point, Black Midi are essentially a genre of their own. Damn all us idiots. Damn us children. Endlessly trying to untie our knots of rivers and roads that defy all sense. Number 1, JPEG Mafia, LP. There's a fear of a nightfall. Peggy's entire career has been building up to this album. On his debut, Black Ben Carson, he sounded hungry. He clearly had a lot of big ideas. On his next album, Veteran, he built on Black Ben Carson and just did everything better. The performances were better, the production was tighter. Then, on his third album, All My Heroes Are Cornballs, he experimented with new sounds, using more sung vocals, more sampling. It had a more lo-fi aesthetic. After releasing two excellent EPs, he announced that due to sample clearances and label disagreements, he would release two versions of his new anticipated album, an online version and offline version, reminiscent of Frank Ocean releasing Endless and Blonde in order to leave his label. The online version would be available on streaming, and the offline version was a free independent Bandcamp release, representing the true artistic vision JPEG Mafia had for this project. These horses can move. I won't even try to. I won't even lie. I'm looking good. I won't even fit. I'm feeling nice. I'm looking good today. I bought a new suit. I'm about to go to work. Okay. Praise God. I feel like celebrating. I ain't been fucked up. Yeah, I've been fucked over. Still going hard. I feel like celebrating. Okay, I'm fucked up. Yeah, I've been fucked over. Still feeling nice. Everything's great. No one else is making music like this. JPEG Mafia is in a league of his own. No one cuts up samples like Peggy does. No one builds songs like Peggy does. No one covers Britney Spears and TLC like Peggy does. This is a masterpiece.
Yes, but you are the hip hop gangster. This bitch around my ass, the ring like some time. This bitch is just my the gangster of the hip hop.
Feel like a bad bitch, I smack it up. It's a closed casket, this flow's mastered. I'm a whole has-been, I know it's tough.
Let me know in the comments if you agree with my picks. If you enjoyed this, then please hit the like button and subscribe. It really helps the channel grow. This is BPM Stuff. Have a happy new year.